UK Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Continue with the exhibition. Irrespective of pass or fail. Okay, it might be pass, it might be fail. Okay, here in verification commands, it will continue with the execution. It validates. It basically, the verification command means it basically validates. After validates, say if it is pass, it will continue the execution. If it is fail, still it is going to continue with the execution. So why I'm saying like, Why I am mentioning it is going to continue the execution. Here, say there are some scenarios, there are some situations where in which if a step fails, okay, if a step fails, we don't want to continue. For example, if a login is failed, say we are automating sending email scenario. So for sending email, say we have login, send some compose email, log out. Say login itself is got failed. Do you continue with the execution of compose email? Do you continue with the execution? I'm saying, say you have a send email scenario. Here, say we have login, we have compose email, and we have logout. Okay. What I'm saying here, say login got failed after you enter username, password. Once you click on sign in, say because of some wrong credentials, say it got failed, it got stopped here in the username, in the login screen itself. Okay. So in that case, do we continue with the execution? No, right? We will not go with the compose email, we will not go with the logout. Because login itself is failed. So technically, if you speak, here there is no meaning in continue with the execution of compose email because login itself is got failed. Here itself we have to raise a bug. Okay. Now in that case, this verification commands are not preferable to use. Okay. Okay. In this case, this is not preferable to use. Probably say you are validating a basic things like say username label is presented or not. Username label is presented or not. A password label these things are okay these things say if the username label is not presented in the application okay still you can continue with the execution because say if the username field is not there probably we may need to have a username text box okay so here if we don't have the username label it is okay. We can still continue with the execution. We can even the username label is not presented. We can go to the next line and we can validate the, whether password label is presented or not. Okay. But here in the previous case, say here the username text box is not there. Say in other words, basically label. I hope everyone knows label text box. Say this is your application. Here generally application will contain like this right username and here we'll have text box okay we'll have password we'll have text box right then you have a sign in or login right I'm talking about a particular page now this is called as a label username label password label and this we call it as a text box, this we call it as a text box, this we call it as a button. What I am saying here, say you are validating username label is present or not. Even this username is label is not presented, even say this step got failed, but still we can continue with the next step, say validating this password. Okay. In this kind of scenarios, you can use verification commands. Okay. So still if this step is failed, still you can continue with the execution by marking the current step as failed. Say you are validating username. Say this step is not presented. The verification commands is going to mark this particular step as failed. And it is still continuing the execution. But in this kind of scenarios, preferable to use verification commands. Okay. Now say here, you have a text box. You say this text box is not presented. Say if this text box itself is not presented, there is no meaning in continuing this functionality, right? I cannot enter the username. So this is a kind of a forcing command. I mean forcing situation. Here if this particular text box is not presented, we have to stop the execution. That kind of mechanism is not there with this verification commands. If the step is failed, it is going to continue the execution. It is not going to stop. That kind of mechanism is not there with the verification commands. That kind of mechanism will be there with the asserting commands. Okay. Now here in assertion commands, what will happen if the step failed, if the validation fails, the execution will be stopped there itself. Okay. If the validation fails, the execution is going to be stopped there itself. Say for example, text box is not presented. Say we are validating this. If this text box is not presented, there is no meaning in executing the scenario. Okay. The other way, say here, once you click on sign in, say the next page, the home page is not appeared. Say user home page is not appeared. In that case, there is no meaning in continuing with the execution, right? In those kind of scenarios, you have to use assertion commands. Okay, so if the validation fails, execution will be stopped here. Whereas here, if the validation fails, it is going to continue with the execution here. Okay, let me give some kind of code here. Let me do one thing. Let me copy the same thing here. Okay, it validates the application and stop. It will stop the execution. If it fails, if the validation fails. Okay, it validates the application. Basically, assertion commands will helpful to validate the application, but it stops the execution if the validation fails. Both verification commands and assertion commands both will be helpful for validating the application. Whereas verification commands, basically, if the validation failed, if the step is failed, still it is going to continue the execution by marking it as a fail. But whereas here in assertion commands, if the step is got failed, it is going to stop the execution. Now here basically the hint, I mean when to use what, it purely depends, it's the other way I can say, when to use what, I mean in which scenario we have to use the application, in which scenario we have to use the assertion means, here basically you should know, it purely depends on your test case. On the test step or test case, okay, or other words, here basically in general, you know, during navigation, when your script is navigating from one page to other page, use the assertion. Use assertions when the application having in navigation in simple. It means, say here you are navigating from login page to say user home page, and then user home page to say logout page. So you are navigating from one page to the other page. In this kind of scenarios, use the assertions. Say if you are validating the same page, use the verifications. Okay, it's just a hint. Okay, and however it is, it depends on the test case. Okay, in general, we use assertions in the navigations. So these are the two types of commands. I will show with an example here. Okay, I will explain this verification commands. I will show this assertion commands. Okay, now the third one is wait for commands. Wait for commands basically helps in synchronization. Synchronization means it will make the tool to wait for some time. It will make the tool to be in sync with the application. It means, say for example, here we have entered username, we have entered password, okay, clicked on sign on. After we click on sign in, say we are expecting a user home page. Okay, say we have entered username, we have entered password, and we clicked on sign in, and then say we get into user home page. Okay, now say this user home page is appearing. Say sometimes it is appearing some 30 seconds, sometimes it is appearing 50 seconds, sometimes say 90 seconds. So it is taking some time to display this whole user home page. Okay, in that case, what you can see here, after you click on sign in, you can say wait for some object to be present. It means you can wait till a home page appears. Okay, wait for command. So by using this command, wait for command, basically you are making your tool to be in sync with the application. Otherwise, say tool basically is not going to wait for this time. It is not going to wait for 50 seconds, 90 seconds. How much time it is going to wait? What is the maximum time that Selenium here it is going to wait? Yep. Just now we were discussing about this. If you observe here, in this options, under this options, here we understood default timeout value for a recorded command line in here in milliseconds. It means it is going to wait for maximum of 30 seconds. Okay. So if it is beyond that 30 seconds, like 50 seconds, 90 seconds, those scenarios, those cases by default will not be, basically it's not going to be handled by using this default synchronization time. Those timings will not be handled because here we mentioned it as 30 seconds. Okay. But however, here we have some command called wait for commands. By using this wait for commands, you can make your tool to wait for some time till the next page appears. Okay. So wait for command will basically helpful to get the next object to be appear. Okay. I will show it. Store commands, here basically we can save the values, saving the values in variables. Okay, here we can save the values here in variables. I will show with some example here. Okay, now first of all we will try to understand verification command. Okay. Now, for example, here if you observe here, we are entering LED TV, we are clicking on this button, and in the next page, here we are entering this LED TV, and we are clicking on the search button. Okay, after page, say we are getting this results page. Right? how can I know whether this results page is appearing or not? Are you getting? How can we know whether this results page is appearing or not? So probably we can take one of the reference. Like for example, if you see this all listings. Say for example, if you are able to see this all listings, it means where we reach this particular page. Right? Or probably if you see this particular section, this complete section, we can conclude that we reach this particular page. Okay. How can I know what are the properties of this? I mean, how can we build the locator for this particular section? Are you getting what I am saying? Once we enter LED TV, once we click on the search button, say here, how can we conclude this results page is appeared? If you can take the, if you can see this particular section, if you can see this particular section, we can conclude this is, we can conclude that we are in the results page. So technically, how can I find the this particular section? Yep, using the locators, right? Now here I am right clicking, I am saying inspect element with Firebug. You can take one of the locator here. Okay, just see here Abdul here, I am just buying this particular section. Now see here, this complete section is having some name. See here, everyone Abdul here, I spy this particular section, or even you can probably you can take even this section, even this section. Okay. See here, even you can take one of the reference of this. Okay, if you can see this all listings, or if you see this particular section, you can conclude that this particular page is appeared. Now observe here, it has some ID, so let me take this ID here. Now here, after this command, after this click and write, I want to include one line. What is the logic to include a statement here? How can I include a statement over here? Right click, insert new command, and here, I am mentioning verify. Here, see here, I am using as of now, we will try to understand verify here. Okay. Here, generally, here, if you observe, these are the verify related commands. If you understand the verification command, accordingly, you can choose your command. Okay. And however, in general, we use one of the famous command is element verify element present. Okay, verify element present. So here you have to give the locator of the element that you are planning to see. See here, I am saying ID equal to this particular ID. Now see here, I am saying fine. It is highlighting that. Now this verify element present, basically it is going to validate whether this particular object is presented or not. If it is presented, it is going to be say pass and continue. Even it is not presented, it will continue. That is what we are trying to understand now. Now Abdul here, now let me remove this particular starting point. Now everyone Abdul here, it is going to execute in the background. Observe here in the background, see here it is entered LED TV, okay. Oh, I mentioned something else here, let me delete this. And however, if you closely observe this particular line, can you observe here, this background of this particular line is being highlighted with more of green color. Okay, so this particular step is got passed. Everyone closely observe here, okay, verify element present. Okay, this particular step is being highlighted with a more green color. Basically, it is a validation point. Okay, now observe here. Now we'll do one thing. I'm intentionally I'm just changing this locator. So here I'm using some intentionally. I have added 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 here. Okay, now we'll try to execute this. Observe here the execution. Now, can you all observe here? Just to avoid the confusion, let me remove this comment as of now. Let me delete this. Now, can you all observe here? Now, it is saying verify element present. This got failed. So, if you observe here in the background, it is being highlighted with a pink color. Okay. and after that next line again executed, it is held in green color. It means it is continued with the execution, right? Even though this step got failed, here it continued with the execution. Okay. Now here we'll try to understand with the verification command, assertion commands. Now let me remove this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 here. Okay. Now here let me use. Here in general we use a command called assert element present. Now observe here, everyone observe here. Now it is executing in the background, it is opening, it is enter LED TV, it clicked on search. Okay. Now it is going to click on the LEDs. Now observe here. This assert element present also highlighted with a more of green color. Okay, this particular step is being passed. Now observe this case. Here I am intentionally changing this locator. I am saying 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Now we will try to execute this statement. Now what it has to do? Now if I execute, what it has to do over here? This has to stop over this particular line. Because we don't have, as we don't have this particular locator is not presented in the application, it has to stop at this particular line here now. Now sir, let me execute this. Now see here, it said this particular step is being failed and it is being stopped. So if you observe this particular line, the last line is not being highlighted with the green color. It is neither highlighted with the green color nor with the pink color. That's simply white color. It means this particular line has been not, it's not executed. Okay, that is what I said. Assertion commands, if the assertion commands fails, it is going to stop the script there itself. Okay, this is the mechanism of the assertion commands. Okay. Now here, say in other words, let us also use wait for here. Okay, now let me remove this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Now here I am using something called wait for element to be present. Okay. Wait for element present. It means after click on this particular button. Of course, here itself there is a command like click and wait. It is going to click and it is going to wait. Of course, here itself we can achieve some synchronization. But however, say here I am saying wait for element. So after clicking on this search button over here, okay, it will wait for this all listings element to be present. Okay, wait for element present. So it's not a kind of a verification. It's just a kind of a it's a kind of a synchronization command. Okay, now if I say here, now see here it is waiting, of course here it is, the application is fast, the application is slow, it would have wait for some time till the this particular object is going to be appear. Wait for element present. Okay. Now here we'll try to understand a store command. Here let me include one new line. Now observe, I am using a command store command. Okay. Now under this reference you can see expression and variable name. Here say I want to store LED TV here. And I am going to give into a, I am going to save into a variable name. I am going to save into a variable. Let me say search for is the variable name. So basically what is happening, this LED TV, this value is being saving in this particular variable. Okay. Now let me go to this command and here we are hard coded. We have mentioned LED TV here, right? Now I am going to replace this LED TV with this parameter, this search for parameter. Okay. Now if we want to make use of it, we have to use this dollar symbol, flower basis. The variable name. This is the syntax for accessing a variable over here. Okay. Now let us try to execute. See here, it is entered LED TV. It means this LED TV has been saved in the search for variable and that search for variable is being used over here. it's a kind of a, like a standard point, standard thing. Okay, here say in this script, in this particular script, say we are going to use four different values. Okay, all those four values will be saved into four variables in the starting of the script. Okay, here we will have three more store commands. Basically, whatever the data that we are going to fill in the script, all those data will be filled during the start of the script itself, so that we'll have an idea what are the variables, what are the different values that we are passing to the script. Okay, so this is called as a store command. So we have been trying to understand this Selenium commands. Okay, now here I will try to understand this IDE context menu. Let me discuss it as Selenium IDE menus. Before that, let me write down the syntax for this one. Syntax for accessing variable. Here it's a dollar symbol, and here flower basis variable name. Okay, this is the syntax for accessing a variable here. And here I said that mainly we use a command called wait for element present. Okay. And whereas here in assertion, we use assert element present. Here we mainly use verify element present. Okay. Now here we have something called Selenium IDE context menu. Okay. So here Selenium IDE context menu means, it's very simple. Abdul here. Now we have Selenium IDE is open. Now everyone Abdul here. Now currently Selenium IDE is open, right? Now if you right click on the application, can you all Abdul here? You can find something like open, some show all available commands. Okay. Can you all Abdul here? Here, under show available commands, you can find the assert related commands, assert title, assert text, assert element present. Just now we discussed, right, assert element. Okay, it contains assert related commands, verify related commands, wait for related commands, store related commands. Okay, so here these are all the options are available, and if you observe the options over here, these options has been increased here. I mean, in general we don't have these many options. Okay, whenever your Selenium IDE is open, if the Selenium IDE is in on, it is open, if you right click on the application, it is going to show the commands which are related to Selenium IDE. This particular options, this is called as basically Selenium IDE context menu. Okay, it means when Selenium IDE is open, if we right click on the application, we can find more options. That more options is nothing but Selenium IDE context menu. For example, just to understand this, say let me close this particular Selenium IDE now. Okay, now see, I have closed Selenium IDE now. Now if you right click on the application, you can see normal options only. You can't find the more options. Can you see here? These are the normal options. But if you again select, if you open again Selenium IDE, here if right click, you can find more options. Open, verify values, this show all commands. Okay, you can find more commands over here. Okay. This is called a Selenium IDE context menu. Okay, and here I have mentioned synchronization commands, which are basically nothing but wait for commands. Both are same. Wait for elements, which is basically synchronization commands, is nothing but wait for commands. By using wait for commands, we can achieve the synchronization. Okay, and here there is a topic called what we cannot record here in Selenium IDE. This let me discuss as part of Selenium IDE. What we cannot work with Selenium IDE. Say if we have any functionality like file upload. Okay, pop-ups, multi-browsers. Okay. These kind of things cannot be recorded using Selenium IDE. Okay. If you have any file uploads, if you have any pop-ups, if you have any multi-browsers, say you click something and it is opening a new browser. Okay, those kind of scenarios cannot be automated using Selenium IDE. Okay. However, we know Selenium can be worked with only web application. So obviously we cannot record the Windows-based applications, the other applications apart from web. Okay, apart from web, we cannot record any other application using Selenium IDE. And moreover here, it can work only with the Firefox. It will work with only with Firefox browser. Okay. Here, and don't get confused here, I'm just talking about Selenium IDE. I'm not talking about Selenium WebDriver. Okay, I'm just talking about Selenium IDE only. Okay. Now we have been trying to understand menus, okay, and then Selenium commands and context menu. Synchronization command, I just mentioned because I wanted to reiterate, synchronization commands is nothing but wait for commands, and what we cannot record over here in the application. Okay.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.